Hello, welcome back to Let's Play Star Trek Judgment Rites Blind. I'm the RPG chick. I normally don't cut off in the middle of an episode like that, but, well, I forgot to save the game. Let me do so now. I have actually done so right after we got here, but...
Save new game.
I'm gonna save a new game. Since I do want to try something. He'll just stand over there. This is something else I want to try, actually. He's showing heightened levels of stress.
Lieutenant Commander Ellis is showing heightened levels of stress.
Right, I don't suppose we can do anything for that. Let me just see. I mean, talking to him doesn't reveal anything new.
I don't see any medical emergency, Jim.
Alright then. He's just stressed out like we all are. Because he knows he's a red shirt. And his life is, could very well be forfeit. So we've got everything we did last time. Let's pour the stuff here.
You cover the straw with schnapps.
And I don't want to leave the guard's body there. Maybe there's another way out. We couldn't seem to get him. The game didn't seem to recognize him as a living being. I couldn't even analyze him. So, I think once we knock him out, that's it. So, let's try something else.
What's going on here?
We should leave this building immediately. The proximity of this fire to a large concentration of alcohol puts us at considerable risk.
No kidding.
This guard looks like he wants you to give him an excuse to shoot.
Do you think the Baron cares if you burn to death?
Who is this Baron? Trelane? Don't be a fool, man. If you keep us in here, you'll die too. It depends on whether he likes his prisoners rare, medium, or well done. Who is this Baron? Trelane? Don't be a fool, man. If you keep us in here, you'll die too.
Right.
You have a point, Kirk. Go. I will be following.
Alright, so there's a better way out. Let's actually go.
Our soldier friend seems to have gotten separated from us. I heard some windows breaking on the other side of the building. I assume that was him.
The building is structurally sound, Captain. I doubt that it would collapse, but as a precaution, I would not enter it again.
Where are we, Mr. Spock?
Isn't it obvious? In trouble.
Do you have a problem, Mr. Ellis?
Yes, sir, I have a problem. His name was...
Trelane? Ooh.
The Baron does not appreciate vagrants.
That's
Why
not nice.
That?
Not very nice at all.
James T. Kirk, who feels a little ragged right now.
Better to be ragged than to be, crispy critter.
Mr. Spock, pondering the illogic of this situation. Dr. McCoy, pondering the unusual nature of this situation.
The unusual nature?
Mr. Spock.
And the illogic.
Lieutenant Commander Ellis glares at Kirk.
Why are you glaring at Kirk? What did Kirk do?
This looks like a man who enjoys his work.
Yeah, great.
This unfortunate soul is screaming for help.
Sorry, first we have to look at everything.
This unfortunate soul...
It's looking at his hat.
A quaint village shop, typical of early 20th century Earth. A quaint village...
Tavern?
A quaint little pub, reminiscent of 19th century German pubs.
It's all so quaint. This smoke isn't quaint, though.
Smoke billows out of the abandoned hovel. The entrance to the hovel.
So it's a hovel. The floor.
Uneven cobblestones pave this European street.
I notice a manhole cover.
This metal grate leads to the sewers of Gothos.
Can't wait to go there.
This placid sky betrays no hint of the danger of your situation. A quaint little pub. The entrance to the pub. The entrance to the shop.
Oh, rather straightforward.
A burnt-out hovel. This is where Trelane placed you after you were taken from the Enterprise.
Indeed he did.
Save new game. Cancel. Delete. Replace previous.
Alright, now that we're out of that. Let's talk to everybody, including ourselves.
Not a bad place to visit, but I can't say I like some of the natives.
Hmm.
This strikes me as something of a Potemkin village, Captain. It lacks the scope to be truly real.
A creation of Trelane's, no doubt. One of his imitations of reality.
Undoubtedly, Captain, there is a high probability that it will be an extremely deadly place.
Indeed. A Pokemon village?
I didn't join Starfleet to play at being a galactic tourist.
All right, Commander, you were about to tell us why you're being so hostile. Let's hear your story.
Yeah.
Does the name Lieutenant Ralph Garvin sound familiar to you?
Garvin.
He was my roommate at the Academy and was killed by some blood-sucking cloud while on a landing party under your command.
Space is not the safest of environments.
Redshirt?
I've always done my best to protect my crew, and I've always honored anyone who has lost their life under my command.
The Enterprise is routinely assigned to unknown and extremely dangerous sectors.
True
that. I've always made it a policy to lead landing parties and share the risk with my men.
That's true. He often does that when he should not.
I suppose you've never lost someone under your command, Commander.
Command Commander.
You've never felt the loss of a subordinate while you've been on a landing party? When you become a captain of a starship, you'll have every right to judgment. We're in the middle of a life and death situation. I expect you to act like a Starfleet officer.
Good point. Laying down the law.
I have always made it a policy to lead landing parties and share the risk with my men.
I think this is the best one, though.
Captain, if I see you do anything that puts us or our escape at risk, you'll regret it.
I'm not interested in vendettas. I'm interested in surviving. If you have a problem with me, you can wait until everyone's safe. Is that clear, Commander?
Yes, sir.
Oh, my.
Why are you talking to me?
Now we're getting like that. Why are you talking to me?
Help me. Please help me, someone.
We'd love to, actually.
Do not interfere, or the same thing will happen to you.
How would you like to pick on someone your own size?
What
has this man done? You're really a tough guy, aren't you? It can't be easy to bully some old man. I'm really impressed.
I love that one.
How would you like to pick on... What has this man done?
That is none of your concern. Do not interfere.
I see. He's done nothing.
Is this real? I mean, are we breaking the... Prime Directive, somehow? Or is this all an illusion of Trelane's? What's this building?
You get no response.
Oh, I didn't want to talk to it.
A building. It was once a bakery.
Once a bakery. What if we go in here? We can't go into the once a bakery? Three times a bakery. Let's check out the Shoppe.
I suppose we're going to let a poor old man get beaten to death by a uniform-wearing thug?
Fine, Mr. Ellis. We'll stay here and deal with it.
He told us not to interfere. We don't have use of our phasers. What are we supposed to be doing? What would you like to do, Mr. Ellis? I suppose you're going to tell me why am I talking to
you. Why are you talking to me?
You were talking to me.
I recommend caution, Captain. I would expect Trelane to have several surprises in store for us.
I didn't join Starfleet.
Yep.
The soldier ignores you.
Well, let's go help the guy. Do we still have our schnapps? We can give him some schnapps.
My hip. I think it's broken. Someone get me a doctor, please.
Oh, a doctor? We have one of those. Why didn't I think of that before?
A human, approximately 60 years of age, in poor physical condition. His hip is broken, Jim. He needs our help.
Correction, he needs your help. Go fix.
You'd better take care of the soldier first.
Oh. Well, can a Vulcan friend do that?
I'm the closest one to him. You keep an eye out for any of his friends.
What are we gonna do, enter in fisticuffs? That was a pretty...
Having fun, Jim?
Quick round of fisticuffs. What's this song?
The bullying soldier might be surprised to have met his match if he were still conscious.
Oh, someone's watching now. There's someone over here.
This seems pointless. This seems pointless.
There's somebody there.
This seems pointless.
There's somebody there.
You get no response.
My hip... Isaac.
Okay, Bones. No more delays, please, for the poor man. Oh, look at his hand wiggling. Let me tell you
that
anything.
That should fix the hip problem. You should rest. Thank goodness Trelane didn't take the tranquilizers from my med kit. He'd probably be too tired to talk much.
Too tired to talk. We'll try anyway.
Thank you for helping me. If only I had something to repay you.
You could tell us where we are.
You are the American pilot, Lieutenant Colonel Jimmy Kirk. The leader
Jimmy
of
Kirk?
The famous Enterprise Squadron.
Lieutenant Colonel Jimmy? Enterprise Squadron?
I suppose I should tell you nothing, but as it looks as though the war will soon be over, I can tell you that this is the village of Gothos.
What war is this?
The Great War. The one that has lasted for 4 damned years and has killed millions. I never thought that it was possible for so many young people to die for such a worthless cause.
I believe he refers to the first of your world wars.
Could you answer an important question for me, sir? What year is this?
I only get one question?
Where's Trelane? What else has happened? What year is this? What else has happened?
What else is happening?
It is rumored that our forces are mutinying, and that our ambassadors have met with Mr. Wilson to discuss an armistice.
Thought he couldn't talk much.
But that Mr. Wilson will not negotiate with anyone except an elected government. Baron Trelane has retired to his castle and sees no one. His men are nothing more than bullies. I am so tired. I must rest.
Not a bad place to visit, but I can't say I like some of the natives.
I didn't join Starfleet.
I recommend caution, Captain.
Anything new to say?
Why are you talking to me?
Oh god, this guy's a real... something wrong with him. And, analyze our friend here. He's probably just unconscious.
He's not going to be bothering anyone for a while.
He needing any help, then?
Jim, do you really want this guy up and around?
I suppose he'll come to eventually.
Yeah, I suppose so. Now, I'm pretty sure she wasn't there before. I can't just talk to her?
You get no response.
Alright, let's head back for the Shoppe, then. I want to go there first, for some reason. Greetings.
Charming place. Less technology, more humanity. I like it.
Somewhere in the middle of this European charm is Trelane and the missing ships. Let's find him.
James Kirk, wondering when Trelane will make his grand entrance. Mr. Spock continues to ponder the illogic of the situation. Dr. McCoy is glad that he is not a doctor in the hospitals of this time period.
Yeah, right. Leeches and stuff?
Lieutenant Commander Ellis wonders where his ship is. This boy looks like he's anxious to make a sale.
We do not have the coin of the realm, though.
A cash register. Candy canes in a jar.
Gumballs.
Jelly beans in a glass jar. A package of food containing mutton.
Cotton candy?
Bottles and cans line the back wall, as well as flowers in a vase.
Flowers in a vase, okay.
Bottles and cans A cash register. Bottles and cans. Bottles and
light?
A light hangs from the ceiling.
There's a lot of stuff in here.
Confections. A package of meat in a white wrapper and a cash register are on this counter.
Correct.
This clock looks expensive. This clock looks like it is broken. You wonder who would want a broken clock. A sturdy wooden table. Sacks of flour and household cleaning implements line this wall. An empty kettle rests upon this stove.
There's so many things here.
A tattered rope sits here. A broom, good for sweeping things. Sacks of flour and household... A rather badly painted seascape. Sacks of flour and house... A wooden floor. A barrel of apples. A barrel of pickles.
Hmm. Apples and pickles. Oh, doubles as a cobbler?
This shop is not experiencing a shortage of shoes.
I wouldn't say so.
Metal buckets in a rough pile on the floor. Pans, dishes, and lamps line this wall. Pans, dishes, and...
If we weren't in Starfleet, we could maybe steal some of this stuff.
Pans, dishes, and... A small stepladder to help the shopkeeper reach the upper shelves.
Okay. I think we've looked at everything.
Sacks of flour.
I don't know if these are doors or cabinets. I guess they're cabinets.
Pans, dishes, and... The shopkeeper has a barber's license.
It's a barber, too. Wow.
Captain, these items are not typical of what would be available in a German shop in the 20th century. I would theorize that Trelane has set this up for a reason.
Could he be testing us? I've read many reports of superior intelligences testing human beings.
Trelane does not qualify as superior intelligence, Mr. Ellis. He's not testing us. He's playing with us. And I'm rather tired of his games.
I guess we're getting shore leave a little early. Sort of.
Here we are in the early 20th century, living in history. It's a shame that this is only a cheap sham by Trelane. I could get to like this place.
I think Bones agrees with you. And why are you talking to me?
This looks safe. I don't think anyone is going to die here. Do you agree, Captain?
One never knows, Mr. Ellis.
Remember, you want me to be very cautious.
Don't push your luck, Mr. Ellis. I don't know. Foot and mouth disease can strike anyone, anywhere, and it can be fatal.
Good one.
One never knows, Mr. Ellis.
Yes, sir.
Does he say it again?
This looks safe.
One never knows, Mr. Ellis.
Yes, sir.
All right, before we talk to the shopkeep, let's analyze everything. Are these people
the
real?
The tricorder detects nothing unusual. This object is composed of metal and wood. There is nothing unusual about it.
Back wall.
The tricorder detects nothing.
Candy?
A curious substance, Captain. I have never understood the human need for sweet confections.
With Vulcan taste buds, it's no wonder.
Actually, Doctor, the need for sweets is more psychological than physical.
You probably say that for everything, though.
A curious substance
with Vulcan taste.
Actually, Doctor, the...
But this mutton.
The tricorder detects nothing unusual.
Furnace.
A common stove, although perhaps a bit antiquated for the period. There are no unusual readings from it, Captain. The tricorder detects...
All right, apples?
Apples, Captain. I detect nothing unusual about them.
Pickles, Captain?
Pickles, Captain. I detect nothing unusual about them.
About these clocks?
The power contained within one of the clocks is off the scale, Captain. It matches with the sensor readings I took of Trelane's triplane on the Enterprise.
Theories, Mr. Spock.
Captain, the last time we encountered Trelane, he used various items, in particular, a machine hidden behind a mirror, as a source for his power. This clock is another one of Trelane's power objects.
And if we could find and destroy enough of Trelane's power...
The village of Gothos would come apart. And we might find out what happened to the Enterprise.
Mr. Spock, continue scanning for power sources.
Cool. We have to destroy that?
Captain, I am unable to filter out the power readings that I am getting from the clock. I cannot effectively scan the surrounding objects.
What about this clock?
Captain, I am unable...
So, we have to find all the Horcruxes to defeat Volderlane.
The tricorder detects nothing unusual.
How about shoes, Spock?
There's nothing unusual about the shoes.
Captain.
The tricorder detects...
One more.
An ordinary oil painting, Captain. I detect no unusual readings.
Now, what is this? Is this anything we can look at?
Jars of fruit are preserved in this translucent container.
Okay, what about the fruit, then?
The tricorder detects...
The stool?
The tricorder detects...
And his license.
The tricorder detects...
Alright, let's talk to the guy.
Hi, can I help you?
What do you want for that room?
I love the accent. Awesome.
I see you're selling food packages.
I'd love to live overseas. Like, I don't know. I've lived in the USA way too long. I want to, you know, I don't know. I want to go somewhere. Be around interesting people for once. No offense, USA people, but I love the accents.
Is that a coil of rope over on the wall? What do you want for those shoes? That really is a beautiful clock. Can you tell me how to make money around here? What do you want for that room?
Can we ask him all this stuff? I mean, why not, right?
That old thing. I can give it to you now. You can pay me later. I'm sure my boss, Mr. Uland, won't mind.
Mr. Uland. Okay, we've got a broom.
This broom shows its age. Worn straw, weathered handle.
A broom composed of straw and wood. Nothing unusual about it, Captain.
Okay. What else can we borrow?
Hi, can I help you?
I see you're selling food packages.
You look hungry. Sure, have it. Pay me later.
Oh, we can take all the stuff? We took mutton. These people are so nice here.
This meat looks like ground beef. You are not certain you like the smell.
Perhaps to feed to some beastie or something.
Uncooked dead animal matter. I believe this came from a pig.
Uncooked dead animal matter. You make it sound so appealing, Spock.
Hi, can I help you?
Is that a coil of rope over on the wall?
Yes, we want all the things.
Is that rope? No one ever buys rope. Go ahead, take it.
Take it. Yep, and one by one we're going to take all the things and we're going to look at them and analyze them. Hope you guys don't mind.
This sturdy rope is made from hemp.
Oh, it's a hemp rope.
An ordinary piece of rope.
Okay. Next.
Hi, can I help you?
What do you want for those shoes?
I'm sorry, but those shoes have already been paid for.
Oh, turn down.
Hi, can I help you?
What do you want for those shoes? That really is a beautiful clock. Can you tell me how to make money around here? What do you want for those? Can you tell me how to make money around here?
Yes.
Sure, have some money. Oh, I don't have any. I wonder why.
What? Have some money.
Hi, can I help you?
What do you want for those shoes? What do you want for those That really is a beautiful clock.
Clock is the last thing left.
It sure is. I can let you have it. Pay me later. Or maybe not. Mr. Uland wouldn't like me to give away something that expensive on a promise.
That's why we need to make money.
Hi, can I help you?
What do you want for those shoes? That really is... What do you want for those shoes?
I'm sorry, but those shoes have already been paid for.
This looks safe. I don't think anyone...
Well, never knows, Mr. Ellis.
Yes, sir.
Anything new to say?
I guess we're getting shore leave a little...
Captain, these items are not typical.
Could he be testing us?
Trelane does not qual... Here we are in the early 20th century.
Gonna try something.
Save new game. Cancel. Delete. Replace previous.
I don't want to lose anything now. Or he's just analyzing it.
The unusual readings are unchanged. It is definitely one of Trelane's power objects.
Please, don't take that clock. My boss would be so upset if something were to happen to it.
We do need the clock.
It's like some bizarre game. Perhaps Trelane is putting us through mazes, watching our moves, and laughing at us.
We can't give Trelane any excuses, any reason to think we've cheated. We'll find the money to buy this clock and stick it down his throat if we get the chance.
You aren't thinking of trying to keep the doctor away, are you, Jim?
Huh. Great. Love it.
I always hated pickles.
Fine, then we won't get any.
Fine, we won't get any.
Captain, I'm real uncomfortable taking items without permission. Starfleet regulations specifically require us to comply with local customs unless it violates our Starfleet oath.
Thank you for the reminder, Commander.
Oh, brother.
Captain, even I'd have trouble lugging that cast iron monstrosity around.
Even you? Huh.
I like candy canes, too.
Absolutely tasteless. I see Trelane's culinary skills have not improved.
I like candy canes, too.
Captain, I'm real uncomfortable.
Thank you for the reminder, Commander.
I don't think we're actually losing points for doing this, so I'm going to keep going.
If Trelane has his way, we'll soon be kicking the bucket.
Maybe I shouldn't take it. The last thing Trelane needs is ideas.
Trying to end our second career as a barber, Jim?
Okay, I'll leave the license alone.
It's worth it just to hear all this.
Captain, I'm real uncomfortable.
Thank you for the reminder.
Captain, the painting has no intrinsic value.
I don't know, Spock. I kind of like it. But I shouldn't take it without permission.
How about we just take the whole register?
Damn it, Jim. I'm a doctor, not Bonnie and Clyde.
Awesome.
Captain, I'm real.
Thank you for the reminder, Commander.
Can we open this?
It looks rather sturdy to me. It looks rather sturdy to me. I don't think this clock is working.
Please, don't take that clock.
We do need the clock.
It's like some bizarre...
We can't give...
What is this? Just notice this.
Bottles and cans line...
Okay. What if we try to take the stool?
Captain, I'm re...
Thank you for the reminder, Commander.
All right, let's go. Well, that lady's gone. And the... Both of the guys are gone. Oh my god, you walk so slow. Keep going.
You know the Baron's orders are that you are to be served in the armory. You are not to enter this establishment.
Is that him?
Everyone knows, Fraulein, that the Baron's orders
Someone
were
else.
Never meant to be taken seriously. Even by him.
Looks like trouble.
Excuse me, but if the lady wants you out, then you should get out. Would you like to step outside?
Oh, tough guy.
Hello, soldier. Wouldn't you look good with beer on your face?
Beer on your face.
Excuse me, but if the lady wants you out, then you should get out.
Yeah, I think so.